Although Christianity in recent years has been frequently billed as the white man's religion or European religion, most people are still well aware of its roots as a movement that, of course, do not originate on the continent of Europe. And although many of the practices, traditions, and philosophies associated with the faith have been heavily influenced by European culture, there were branches of early Christendom that stretched past the confines of what we would define as the Western world. There were early Christian groups in Ethiopia, who are still around in large numbers to this day, by the way, along with places as remote as Central Asia and the Far East. But today we're going to focus on the early Christian churches of South India, along with other groups around them, such as South Indian Hindus, Muslims, Jews, and Buddhists in the region, that share a similarly interesting origin. It's important to separate fact from fiction and be objective on this subject, especially considering this period of mass politicization of history, and I will say that it did come as a huge surprise to me when I was a kid to learn that there were Christians in India, especially when I learned that the group was already well established nearly 1,000 years before such places as Sweden or Norway had adopted the faith. This group of Indian Christians has had their own variety of Christianity, which remained uninfluenced by major European powers for thousands of years before discovery by Western explorers. And what's interesting about this community, though, is that it seems to be pretty much as far away from the origin of the religious group as possible in the country of India, being located in the far south in the state of Kerala. So how on earth did this isolated group get there, seemingly without leaving any trace of their path from the Middle East? The Christian community of South India, known as St. Thomas Christians or Nasrani, were actually predated in the region by Cochin or Malabar Jews of South India, with the first Hebrew-speaking Jews from the kingdoms of Israel and Judah having first visited the region almost 3,000 years ago. Although Jewish settlement in the Chera kingdom in the modern-day state of Kerala in South India wouldn't really take off until around 600 BC. The St. Thomas Christian community was naturally founded by Thomas of Galilee, who originated in the Roman province of Judea and traveled to India in the year 52 AD. Thomas, who was an Aramaic-speaking Jew, settled into the already well-established community of the Cochin Jews in Kerala and converted a handful of Jews and native Dravidian Malayali-speaking peoples before he was killed in 72 AD, yet his small congregation remained for hundreds of years. It does, however, seem extremely dubious that all of the 6 million Nasrani, or 18% of Kerala's population, are descended from this small community. The group would receive a large boost in numbers a few hundred years later when Syriac Christian traders and missionaries from the Sassanid or Neo-Persian Empire settled onto the coast of Kerala and were surprised to find a burgeoning, albeit small, Christian group already established there. They integrated into the former Christian people groups and retained their religious practices, which is why the Nasrani are commonly referred to as Syriac Christians, a title which they share with modern Assyrians, Chaldeans, and Aramaeans of Middle Eastern countries like Iraq and Syria, although the Nasrani only speak Aramaic for liturgical purposes and largely speak Malayali as a first language, like their neighboring Mulus of Hindu and Muslim origin. In the 2,000 years since, the Nasrani have divided into dozens of smaller denominations, being mostly split between Orthodox and Catholics, with small Protestant denominations popping up recently as well. Although the Cochin Jews have essentially had their presence erased from the state of Kerala, as over 99% of the community has emigrated to Israel, the Nasrani are still an important factor in politics and culture in the state. Their culture's unique blend of Malayali, Syriac, Persian, Judean, and most recently a slight Western influence from the British rule in India, with many of the Anglo-Indians who are half European and half Indian of Kerala having assimilated into the Nasrani, seeing how they were Christian as well. Although in appearance most St. Thomas Christians are indistinguishable from neighboring Dravidian populations, judging by haplogroup identification, about 8 to 16% of the gene pool of St. Thomas Christians is of Middle Eastern origin, most likely from the area of the Levant, while the bulk of the rest of their DNA is identical to that of the surrounding South Asian Dravidian groups, such as the Malayali or Tamil. In recent years, around 20% of the Nasrani have migrated outside of the state of Kerala, with there being around 400,000 in the Persian Gulf region alone, while smaller numbers have migrated to North America and the United Kingdom. The Mangalorean Catholic community of Goa are an unrelated people with a much more recent history, but are fundamental to the Indian Christian community as well. The Christians and Jews of South India are not the only group that are allegedly of partial foreign Middle Eastern extraction in the region of southern South Asia, seeing how Tamil-speaking Muslims from both Tamil Nadu and Sri Lanka both claim descent from Arab travelers and merchants, and here's where things get really controversial. Ethnicity and religion in Sri Lanka has always been a heavily politicized topic for years, ever since the independence of Sri Lanka from the UK, and even before the arrival of the British, Dutch, or Portuguese. For some context, the largest ethnic group in Sri Lanka are the Sinhalese, who are unique in the region, seeing how they're one of two Indo-Aryan-speaking groups lying within the Dravidian homeland, with the other being the Divehi of the Maldives and Lakshadweep, with both being partially descended from ancient Bengalis, and additionally, they are the only remaining Indo-Aryan or Dravidian ethnic group that predominantly practices Buddhism. Now, although Tamil-speaking peoples are mostly confined to the state of Tamil Nadu in southern India, there's also a large number in northern Sri Lanka, with around 25% speaking Tamil and 75% speaking Sinhalese. Not all Tamil-speaking groups in Sri Lanka identify as the same ethnic group, however, as the Tamils that live in Sri Lanka can be divided into three main groups. Tamils that have lived in the region for 4,000 years, known as Sri Lankan Tamils, much more recent Tamil migrants from the state of Tamil Nadu in the mainland of the subcontinent, known as Indian Tamils, and Tamil-speaking Muslims on the coast, known as Sri Lankan Moors, that claim at least partial descent from Middle Eastern traders. The Sri Lankan census counts these three groups as separate ethnicities, despite all speaking the same language, although it is true that these groups do have distinct cultures to an extent. The controversy arises with the 1983 Sri Lankan Civil War, when Tamil groups desired a separatist state called Tamil Eelam, encompassing much of northern and coastal Sri Lanka, with radicals even calling for unification with Tamil Nadu and independence from India and Sri Lanka as an ethnic Tamil state. Mass civilian casualties and various war crimes were alleged to be committed by both sides during the war, with many Indian Tamils being deported back to India and hundreds of thousands of Sri Lankan Tamils fleeing the violence to either Europe, Canada, or the United States. Victory in the Sri Lankan Civil War was only recently declared by the Sri Lankan government in 2009, making it a decades-long conflict that has left deep rifts and scars between the people of the region, but we're getting a bit off topic here. Out of the Indian and Sri Lankan Tamil population combined, around 70% are Hindu and 30% Christian, although the Sri Lankan Moors are now more numerous than Tamil Christians, located on many areas of the island. The Sri Lankan Moors get their name from early Portuguese explorers that visited Sri Lanka, then known as Ceylon, who named them after the North African Moors that had long occupied the Iberian Peninsula. Although the group of nearly 2 million is completely unrelated to the North African Moors, it is believed that at least a small proportion of the Moors' DNA originates from the Arabian Peninsula, especially regions in Yemen and Oman, and their impact can be seen in many aspects of the Moors' culture, such as a handful of Arabic words that are used exclusively in the Moor community, and many Moors are beginning to self-identify as Arabs rather than Tamils. The other, much smaller Muslim group in Sri Lanka would be the Sri Lankan Malays, who number 40,000 and are a conglomerate of many Austronesian Muslim ethnic groups from Malaysia and Indonesia, who have been migrating to the island for hundreds of years, as well as significant genetic input from the native South Asians, along with minor input from the British and Dutch. They speak a unique language known as Sri Lankan Malay, which is a blend of Malaysian, Tamil, and Sinhala, being unintelligible with standard Malay from Southeast Asia. The small Malay community of Sri Lanka has been reciprocated, with Malaysia and Singapore having the largest Tamil communities in the world outside of their region of origin. A small percentage of the Sri Lankan Christian population are a mixed-race group known as the Burghers, a corruption of the French word bourgeoisie, meaning upper class, seeing how the Burghers were seen as social and political elites on the island of Sri Lanka up until independence from the UK. The British, Dutch, and Portuguese all established colonies in Sri Lanka, with the oldest being the Portuguese occupation, although the Dutch managed to conquer the island from the Portuguese and expelled all ethnic Portuguese citizens, although the small mixed-race population descended from Portuguese traders and Sinhalese, along with the small Sephardi Jewish population, was allowed to stay. The Burghers are a mix of this original mixed-race group, along with the Sephardi Jews, Dutch, English, Tamil, and various other South Asian and European groups. Their culture is largely a mix of Western European, Jewish, and South Asian customs, with the group being divided between Protestants and Catholics. The Christians, Muslims, and Jews of the various South Asian countries prove that religions and cultures can without a doubt be multifaceted, taking on many of the characteristics and traditions of their new region. For instance, most South Asian Christians and Muslims largely dress in the traditional South Asian attire of the neighboring Hindus in their religious ceremonies, albeit with a slight twist, reflecting their respective cultures that their faith originates from. Go ahead and let me know your thoughts on the various South Asian groups, such as the St. Thomas Christians, the Sri Lankan Moors, Burghers, and other ethno-religious groups with a unique origin. I know this video is sort of all over the place, but we'll be sure to talk about other groups such as the Anglo-Indians and Sidis in a video yet to come. As always, thanks for watching everyone. This has been Mason, and I'll see you next time.